and would use the mechanic skill. Oh, hello. Hello. And fucking deed. Hey, everybody. Welcome back. Falcon, NEO Scavenger. We are playing, obviously, the extended NEO Scav mod. And we are here at the ATN camp, which we finally got here to last time. So we already found information about the talisman that we wear, why we wear it, why we're trying to get rid of it. Unfortunately, the answers aren't really there, but at least we learned a little bit. Now that it's done with, we have a chance to, number one, heal ourselves, number two, sit down for a meal, and also trade. So I'm happy about all this. Number one is go visit Joe, because if we do have any sort of illness, I want him to cure it from us right now. Let's see, you head towards a cluster of tents near the edge of camp, by the forest. Patients reside here helping to tend the area, many of which are in rehabilitation from drug addiction and other conditions. Warriors are more visible here, keeping the peace in an area where frustration and desperation can overcome the healing. Ahead, there is an oblong dome hut, from which steam emanates into the cool air. A man adorned in bear symbology seems to be prepping the hut. This is Joe, Midawani of the Nuke Dudam. Clean and dress wounds, ask Joe to treat illness, and let's ask him to treat illness in case I do have the Wendigo thing. that fucking word. In Anishinaabe medicine, much of the focus is on purifying the body and spirit. The role of heat, smoke, and steam is to infuse the patient with spiritual energy, believed to be symbolized when smoke and steam emanates from the sacred items. In the sweat lodge, Joe conjures the spiritual energy, the spirit of Earth, by pouring water on heated stones. The steam and burning sage fills the room and your lungs, replacing negative energies with positive. So player has received sweat lodge treatment. Nice. There is an indirect science of the medicine as well. Having observed the animal world's interaction with nature, certain plants and animals have been singled out for their healing properties. Bear root, boiled in water to extract the medicine, can have restorative effects. Some even have reported illnesses waning under its effects. Chewing on the root and sipping the tannin tea, your body gains the newfound energy for combating illnesses. Ooh, nice. You thank Joe for this time, for his time and help, and then leave the lodge. Oh, nice. Alrighty. So we chewed on some bear root, and we also drank some tannin tea. Now then, we want to go back there and also dress our wounds, so you head towards a cluster of tents near the edge of camp by the forest. I cannot treat you again. I have too many other patients. Oh, okay, so can't do it any more times. I hope that our injuries were also treated, though. Maybe it's just one or the other. Who knows? Alright, so maybe we'll come back here if we have any more issues. So let's actually sit down for a meal. You approach the long table and find an open place on the bench. The food here is plentiful and appears to be a mix of roasted and dried meats, roasted corn or maize, baked squash, and beans. There is also an assortment of berries and other fruit. Overall, the meal is hearty, with diverse flavors of savory and sweet. It fills your stomach, briefly allowing your mind to wander from minute-to-minute survival. Okay, the feeling here is of one of sharing and respect. Visitors to the table are asked to pay respects to the animals that gave their meat, the three sisters for their fruits, and all creation. In the distance, you see fields of crops, but also semi-trailers, sheets of tarps over frames, and other repurposed grow-ups of their food. You begin to understand the real sense of urgency that perimeter patrol must feel watching over this place. The fine line they walk in keeping rubble scum out, but allowing peaceful travelers pass it. Alrighty, so I wonder, can I eat until I'm completely sated? Let's find out. Try it again. You've been making yourself quite a home here today. Maybe you can come back later, save some food for the others. Alright, so I can't eat anymore. Well, I guess I'm not too salty about it. I'm still malnourished, but, you know, maybe we could go back out and, you know, eat more humans and get the window thing again. No, we're not going to do that, but we're still in a bit of a troubling spot. Hopefully, the trading post could help us out, though. So, the trading post seems to be a place where travelers resupply and offload items. Sorry, I was reading it as two different words. Offload, not offload. Items which may be of use to the Anishinaabe. A large portion of the inventory appears to be handmade items for local materials and some scavenged goods, pickup items to purchase items or drop them to sell. Alrighty, here we go. Alrighty, so here we go. So, I was looking at this, I'm like, really? You guys gonna sell me a campfire? I like to imagine how you're gonna do that. And here is the penis club, the Anishinaabe war club. I really want that. So, 32.44, 35 bucks. We have no money right now, so let's make money. And let's start off with selling smartphone, $17, donated, take it. $17, so basically all you do is just put the item down and it'll give you the money, 17 bucks right there. I would love to hold on to the shotgun shells, but we don't even have a shotgun. However, when I get a shotgun, then it'll be like, oh, I have no bullets for it. So, how do we play this? We are ranged, remember. We are a ranged class, so we should probably consider doing it. Although, we're going to get the bow here anyway. So, this is a really good bow. So, we could just make our arrows and then just kind of fly that way, huh? So, you know what? 12 gauge, let's sell you. 50 bucks is actually nothing to scoff at because we do need this to make the bow, or buy the bow. So, we're up to 167. I could buy the bow now. Perfect. I also want to get the war club. So, baseball bat, we are done. So, let me first and foremost start off with the club here. Boomski. I don't need the stick either, so you could, you know, have that, I guess. Free, on the house, don't worry about it. I'm a nice guy. So we have that. What else? We have 164. Still enough for the bow, mind you. However, if we get the bow, we're going to have to more than likely get our crowbar out of here. But then what we could do is just put this in my hand now and roll this way. So crowbar for looting. And then we have this guy over here for fighting, and we have our bow on our back. I like it. That's a good idea. So that's good. What else? What else do we have to sell? Well, we have this cell phone. Don't care about that. Have it. Tester. Don't care about it. Have it. A handful of ashes I'll hold on to. Handful of flour. Anything else here? We have the morphine. I'm going to hold on to the morphine just in case I get into trouble myself and I might need it, so I'll hold on to that. There's a flashlight, too. Oddly enough, I have a flashlight, so instead of using the flashlight, I always make torches, you know, Falcon logic, right? Let's see, let's go over here, and we do have coffee, don't we? Hey, you guys want to buy some coffee? 17 bones? Yeah, yeah, you know what? Empty this shit out. There you go, take the coffee. You know what, I could actually make a lot of coffee right now and sell it off. Oh, oh, nope. Excuse me. I'm not done here. Trading post. Well, what I want to do is go into the crafting meeting to make my coffee, but I guess you can't do that from here. You have to leave and then come back. Alrighty, well, if that's the case, then we'll deal with it soon. Berries I actually would love. And also this meat. And also the cured meat I want to take with me. It's going to make me thirsty, but at least it'll kind of last us a bit longer, so it'll, you know, give us some proper food down the line. Now, do we want this right here? This is the Gismic Much Stick. I honestly have no idea what this is for. Unlit. What the fuck is this thing for? Smudge stick. Not sure what that's for. Bear root is what I was chewing on, so maybe this will be kind of important to take too, especially if we get sick or something. I do want to grab the arrows, obviously. And, oh, you know what? The bow came with, arrows? Is this mine or is that theirs? Broadhead arrow. You know what? This has to be theirs because there's no way I had 100% quality arrow on me. So this goes over here as the duffel bag. I get you. So you know what? No, don't want it. I'll hold on to my duffel bag if you don't mind. It's a little bit bigger. That's what she said. So yeah, I don't want that. We're good. Rawhide patch. We can make some gloves with this, I guess. You know, carrots. Make our soup. Potatoes. You know what? I'm starving anyway. You might as well just load up on food, right? Can I actually just eat it straight up here? Do you guys mind that? No, you guys don't mind it. As long as I pay, I can just eat it right here. That's fine. Just chow down, then. Perfect. Alrighty. That's done with. Sterilized water. 10. Okay. 10 MT I would love to take, just because it's actually pretty good. 23 bones, though. I'm not sure about that. I'm not too crazy about that. Yeah, I could drink the water here, but you know what? I could always purify water quite easily, so that's a waste of money. Let's not get too crazy with spending money here if we don't have to. Let's just eat this, though. $4, it's worth it. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Alrighty. Potatoes and berry root. I thought you were... Oh, bear root and berry root. Huh. Okay. Interesting. Anything else I could sell right now? Anything in here? No, I don't want to sell my noise traps. That's just a bottle. Flour. We have a strap in there. Don't want to sell the Pharaoh bag. Probably the wrench, maybe? Not really. I use the wrench to cook anyway, right? Some parts in here. Yeah, I think that's about it. I don't see anything that... Oh, yeah, you know what? We have two of these bad boys, right? So let me hold on to condition 58. So here, take that one. I'll take this one. Excuse me? Excuse me, you come over here, okay? You're not going anywhere. All right, there we go. So we have that. Yeah, you know what? I am, because we want to buy this cured meat to take with us. So let me plop this down over here. This over here. All right. And we also want to take the potatoes for cooking purposes down the line. So let's move you over here for now. Oh, you know what? I have some painkillers too. So how much would one painkiller? $5? You know what? Take that. Leave me 4. So there you go. Take those right there. That'll put us at 105. That's not too bad. Morphine would be pretty good, but I'd rather hold on that just in case I need it down the line. That's about it. Alrighty, so let me now get the potato off of you. Handful of ashes. Yeah, you could have them. I don't care. Take these potatoes, and then take the carrot as well. Carrot takes up more spots. Unfortunate, but it's true. Alrighty, there you go. Anything else? Berry root and bear root. I kind of want to take those, even though I'm not entirely sure how to use them, but I still kind of want to take them. Oh, and tenancy, we want this. Alrighty, guys, so I went ahead and I rearranged some stuff around, so as you can see, I was able to move the tarp back over here, so we're fine now. I really want to make use of this tarp wall a bit more, but goddamn is it busting my balls. How much is this one, by the way? 5 bones? You know, for $5, I think we should make the trade, right? I mean, ours is about to break down, 50.9, this one's 100, it's only $5 anyway. You know what? That's not the worst idea I've ever had. Let's rearrange this over here, and let's, if we can, empty this out. This is my shit, guys, right? Don't get crazy. Don't take my stuff now. This is mine, this is mine. So let me drop this one down. I will take the one that's in better condition. Not a fan of the Travois, but you know, for now it's kind of getting us through. Place this over here, and then you over here. Did I leave anything else here? No. This is all theirs now, correct? Yes. I sold off one of the military stripes because I have an extra one over here anyway. Okay. And that's fine. We are set to go. This is a travel I just sold off. We're going to run off out of here with $41. I think that's pretty good. All things considering. I'm not leaving anything behind, right? No. Okay, so we're done. We are absolutely done here. So, we already did that. Leave the village. So we're leaving, you know, still hungry, but better than we started off with, so I'm happy about that for sure. And here we go. ATN Enclave is right there in our map now. We know where to go whenever we get a little bit too worried about our chance of survival. I wonder if just going back right now will let me get another meal in. Kind of something to consider. Alrighty, so from here, we want to go to the fairgrounds, I did say. So, you know, let's actually head towards the fairgrounds. Now, if I'm right, the fairgrounds is actually north and west of the cryo facility. So, I think it's roughly, let's see, going upwards. Maybe somewhere here. So if that's the case, let's actually start making ourselves back over here. We're going to have the war club equipped. Nice, and everything else seems pretty good. We could, at some point or another, get a rest in. But we will do that afterwards. So let me end my turn here. And my clean rags have fallen apart. Let's see. Minor cut, minor pain. Dirty rags. So we could remove this now. No need to have that on. And I do have a dirty rag thing, don't I? I do. So let's just place you in there for now. At some point or another, we have to do clean our rags, by the way. Because we have, I think we only have like one left if I'm right. So we are ready to go. Let's go forward. There is water here. You know what? Let's actually use this a bit and grab some water for ourselves. Because we have the tannin tea. We have infected water. Yeah, so let's actually stock up here so we could, you know, purify this down the line. Everything else here filled up? Does seem like we're filled up. Alrighty, perfect. And, I mean, our thirst is an issue right now, but it's going to be an issue down the line. And one more move. And this way, right into a forest, of course. Not a big surprise there. There is a shack over here, though, so that's a good thing. Anything to scavenge over here? Not quite. So what if we instead... You know what? Let's actually purify this water while we're at it. Get it out of the way. Might as well roll around with it, you know, in cured water instead of infected water. We'll do this, go into the crafting menu, and do our same old song and dance over here. Start the lit campfire, confirm and clear that out, and then we will go into... Excuse me, don't take that off, is that still mine? It is, alrighty. Don't remove my shit without telling me, game. Although I'm pretty sure that was my fault, but you know, I don't like to blame myself, I always blame the game. It's a lot easier for me to deal with it that way. Clear, boil, clear, boil... I'm saying boiled, not boil, like I'm, you know, doing some sort of Irish thing here. Hey, Boyle, how you doing? Not even sure if that's how Irish people sound. I'm pretty sure it's not. Don't be offended if you're Irish. Alrighty, so, do that one, that, and that. Excuse me? All right, so everything's sterilized. We don't need to drink any of it right now, but at least it's there, saved, ready for us to go. And we have 2.3 moves left. Let's continue going forward. Unfortunately, we do have to trek through some of these woods, so that's going to cut down our traveling a little bit. Hey, this is a ATN warrior, so they're cool. They're cool people, offer to talk. This is not a place for talking, he says, paying attention to something beyond. We may talk later. Alrighty, man, don't worry. It's all good. Just wanted to see how you were. But if you don't want to talk, then I understand. I will respect your wishes. Let's go down this way. There's a town over here. Have I checked this place out before? I do believe I have. So let's just walk down over here, which I haven't checked this one out. Now, where is this relative to Zomzoms? Okay, so I'm going to basically guide myself from Zomzoms to make it to the fairgrounds now. Let's scavenge this area where we're at it, though. Crumbling apartment building. We'll use their area. We'll use the crowbar and the mechanic skill. Found a few items here. Cardboard box, infected water, and more rags. So a mulligan stew. Not sure if we have that one, but let me just do that in case we don't. You know what? We might be able to do this really soon. Because it requires a medium flame, a sharp edge, container, two chunks of meat, water, mushroom, potato. Oh, we need the mushroom. Mushroom, potato, and carrot. We do have the potato and the carrot. We just need the mushroom. Now, I wonder if, since I don't have the botany skill, I can't tell if a mushroom is poisonous or not. And the mushrooms are 50-50 chance whether it's going to be poisonous or not. So I wonder if just making it into the stew, say you have a poisoned mushroom, if tossing in the stew will make the whole stew poison, or it would maybe just making the stew negate the poison? You know, I wonder. Not entirely sure about that one. So Shack in the Forest we will check out. We'll use the crowbar, and we'll use the mechanic skill. Oh, hello! Hello! And fucking deed. I feel like going back to the ATN cab and selling this off right now. That's a lot of free money. I mean, I guess I'll hold on to it in case we run into a pistol ourselves, but that is such a good loot. Scrap of paper, more coffee. I know a place for you, my friend. Right about here. Oh, never mind. Flip over. There you go. And clean rags, yes. We definitely do need a few of those. Where's my clean... Excuse me? Why do I get the feeling we're missing something? Why do I get the feeling we're missing something here? Okay, for some reason... Pants, excuse me? I get the feeling we're missing something here. This blue frog sash, I'm not even sure if it's worth it just because it's always like covers up what I have in my hoodie. It's kind of really fucking annoying. We had a little container here, mind you. I do remember that. What was that? Wasn't that part of our hoodie? This is part of our pants, right? I don't know what the fuck was in there. We had another container here, though, unless I'm just tripping out. I guess I could be. But I'm pretty sure that's where we had the clean rags, which you don't have anymore. So, alright, whatever. I mean, I fucked that up. At least it was nothing too major this time. I do want to take the clean rags, though. Which is now a problem because I have no proper place to put it. Can I place you in the travel? I can. Thank you. The travel is so finicky about what you can put in it and whatnot. So that's all fine right here. All good. Let's continue going forward. This is just a scrap of paper. Don't really need that. Although, Mulligan Stew, I think I'm done with you as well. Although, you know what? I say I don't need it, but you could make arrows with the scrap of paper. So maybe for now, just because it's not really taking up any important space, we'll take it. But once we require the space, we'll get rid of it. No big deal. Shack in the Forest? Are you going to make another Shaquille O'Neal reference? Nah, I'm not. You know, I think I have worn out my Shaquille O'Neal in the forest jokes already. There is another flare here. We will take that. Excuse me? You go here, I did say. Handful of flour, another wrench. Nah, it's alright, man. We already got that wrench. And yeah, we're fine. So, scavenge. Whoop, we're done with scavenging, so let's end our turn. Up, ATN warrior. How you doing, man? Don't worry, I'm just over here scavenging. If this is your place, then I apologize, but it's kind of unguarded, and I'm finding some pretty decent loot. So, if you don't mind, I will continue being a thieving scumbag. Let's put this right about here. That'll work. No, more morphine, yeah. This is, like, an amazing loot spot. I'm so glad we found this. That place here, yeah. And then, oh, sweet, this one's even actually working, too. I like it. Chances are I can't put this into Travois, though. So I don't like that. Because we have no room for it unless I get rid of a bottle or something over here. Oh, god damn it. Alrighty, scrap of paper. I think we found when you're not needed anymore, which is now. There you go. All right. Three moves left. I'm malnourished. So at this point, we could essentially just start chowing down on this right here. It's going to make us thirsty, but we do have the water to counter, to kind of counter-effect that, so... Let's have that. Have that. Didn't make us too thirsty, but might as well just drink some now, just to be on the safe side. There we go. All of our four moves left, and let's continue then. War club. I'm really excited to stab, or like, not stab somebody. If I could stab somebody with this club, I have to be quite a powerful individual, but I'm kind of excited to just kind of bash someone with this war club. Just because the whole... Look at it, man! I told you, I wasn't joking around. It said it looked like a phallus. It does. Scavenge. Nothing here. Confirm, cleared out. More water, that's fine. We don't need water at the moment. Now, let's see. Fairgrounds is going to be... 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 16, 17. Over here somewhere. So, jump in here and turn. So I believe it's going to be somewhere up in this little area. So as long as we keep traveling that way, we should be relatively fine. We're malnourished again. God damn it, it's getting so annoying, the whole malnourishment over and over. Inventory, nothing of value here. I could scavenge here. Is there anything to scavenge? No, yeah, just some apartment buildings. Might as well take advantage of that. What did we find there? I kind of clicked too fast. I found another leather utility belt. That's what we're missing, the leather utility belt. Okay. That's what I left behind, I think, at the ATM camp. It's fine. I mean, I had nothing of value in there. I think I had, like, you know, shards and a clean rag, if I'm right. Let me take this wheel now, just in case we ever get the chance to make our, you know, our box cart. We will make it, so might as well take advantage of that now. Shards already do have a few, so I'm not interested in those. That's about it here. Let's check out the scavenging spot one more time. Oh, end of turn. Okay. Not crazy about being malnourished all the time. Okay, found quite a few items here. Clothing, blue jeans, cargo pants, cornicola, eh. But nothing really is going to make or break our run, though. Let's keep going upwards. Oh, that would help out quite a bit. So here's what we do. We go in here. Crowbar, you, my friend, are going on my back because we're going to try to hunt this fucking deer now that we have some range on us, too. Do I want to use the broadhead arrow on a deer? Primarily not. So, let's put you here, place you here, and this over here. Wait a minute. So this is broadhead, and this is broadhead. Crude broadhead, crude broadhead. So they're all broadhead. Alrighty. This is a good arrow, so I'm going to save that for, you know, a really dangerous endeavor. Alrighty, so here's the thing. We just need to make sure that this deer doesn't run off. Of course, the moment I say that, it's the first thing it fucking does. Oh, come on, deer. Oh, stay right there. Okay, you piece of shit motherfucker. Next episode, we hunt deer, bro. Hopefully you guys enjoy. I'm not sure why I said we hunt deer, bro. What am I, PewDiePie or some sort of, like, you know, Madden NFL gamer? I don't even know. Hopefully you guys enjoyed it. If you did, I'd give it a thumbs up. Leave a like. The support does mean a lot. And I apologize for that. We hunt deer, bro. I mean, I do say bro, but that was in a really awkward context. I will catch you next time.